Perfect.
Okay, we'll see how it goes. We also got another guy here hopefully working as a cameraman. Team Fishbed, be advised the server is up. The password is 2238. I'm going to put it in your team chat here. It's F-5 versus MiG-21 match. Okay, Team Tiger.
Yep.
I'm going to put the password for the server in the chat here where it won't be seen on stream. The server is up. It is F5 versus MiG-21 match here on 1.5's browser. Okay, there you go, guys.
Thanks.
No problem. Okay, Twitch viewers, I've been ignoring you guys. I apologize. So I've got a lot I'm juggling here. Hang tight. We are rolling here. The server's up, so the match is going to start soon. So just stay patient, stay tuned if you can. Okay, Team Tiger, anybody having trouble finding the server? It's F5 versus MiG-21 grudge match.
Connecting.
My DSS is still loading.
I'm sorry, sir. Say again.
My DSS is still loading. I'm about to join.
Okay, no problem. All right, I'll be back in a couple minutes to check you guys in the pit.
Hey, Joss.
Yep, go ahead.
Is there, hey, where do you want me anywhere particular when I'm picking, like tactical commander or anything like that?
Is that you can fine? Take game master on the other team. You'll be able to see right. Everything. Try all to focus on footage on both teams and switch back and forth to the action if you can, if you're going to do any recording. If not, don't worry about it. Just keep an eye open for anything weird.
All right.
Cool, hey, Ball Daughter.
Go ahead, bud.
Am I on your wing today?
I don't know if we're going to do a, we still need to kind of have a little, conversation about how we want to, what kind of tactic we want to use today. So I'm just waiting for, Hook and Air Dog to get us set up and then, not that they're going to share our, information with anybody, but, we'll let them finish up and then we'll have a little chit chat about what we're going to do.
Okay. Kinda, if you only knew how much money I was making to get this info.
Espionage is a weird thing, man.
No whisper target found. No whisper target found.
Oh, we have three tanks.
Hey guys, if I could have your attention real quick, this is the event moderator here. We're going to give all the pilots a couple more minutes to pit. I'm showing three pilots on Team Tiger and four on Team Fishbed.
Hey, Ball 11 is pitted. Go ahead and call out if you are.
Zucker's in the pit.
Okay, Twitch guys.
Copy, Zucker.
So I'm going to try to answer a couple of questions here, if we have any. Now we just have Top Ace Tony Keto, Top Ace Tony Keto. So I guess Tony Keto's got some fans in here. I'll have to let him know. Looks like we got 21 viewers. That's good. Appreciate you guys tuning in here. We are within a couple minutes of the match starting. Right now we are just waiting for the pilots to pit, and then the action will start.
Viper's in the pit.
Copy, Viper.
One missing.
All channels, this is event moderator here. We are one pilot short on Team Tiger. Everybody else pitted. Hey, Ufric, if you read, are you okay, bud?
Yeah, I am. The server's still loading. I don't know why.
Okay, we'll give it a second here. Hopefully you'll hop
in. I think I am already in the server. Am I?
Yes, I see you in spectators, just not in in channel yet, or in aircraft. Okay. Team Captain, this is your time to brief, if you so choose. So definitely, if you guys want to discuss strategy, don't let me interrupt that.
Roger that. Okay, gentlemen, I am all ears as far as any input. You know, it's a catch-22, like as the brief stated, we have... an opportunity to go attack their airbase. It is a known area. However, the opposing team may be considering the same. So, since we're short, since we're only with five aircraft, we're either going to split up two to three. I think we should at least split up a little bit, not necessarily too far apart where we can't see each other. But I think we should at least patrol the airspace and see if we can at least defend it. But we should push north, at least to bullseye. I don't think we should push further base at this point in time. Does anybody have any input on that?
I think that's a good idea. I think we should go 2 and 3. Me and Zooter's already practiced with this, so we'll take the flight of 2. I don't think we should take the base. I think we could focus on the mids and take them down. I think we probably outmatch them as long as we cover each other.
Roger.
We definitely outmaneuver them. They can just outrun us. So I think we take them. I think we only take one center line, though. We don't need three tanks, so I think we all
Roger that.
Attention all pilots. Attention all pilots. We are unpausing the server in 30 seconds. In 30 seconds at that time, you will be given the time to load your aircraft and start and taxi and hold short your active runway. At that time, I'll check in with the captains, and once we're all holding short, we will go fight on. 30 seconds.
You good with that, Suter?
Yeah, way good with that. Two, I would stress guns first and missile second, because that MiG can run away whenever he wants. So if you can get him close, use
okay,
your
guns. Twitch viewers, hook here. Our side party is like starting here in just a few
also,
seconds
that,
after all this waiting.
Seeker,
appreciate
you
guys tuning
fire,
in.
Them,
I'm not ignoring you. I'll try to answer questions
the
to the best
so
of my ability, but I'm running back and forth between two computers and four screens, so
personal
bear with
experience,
me.
If you jettison anything, even your tanks, don't descend.
Lessons
Roger
learned.
That. It's a straight and level on jettison.
Okay, yeah, dog. Unpause server. Unpause server.
All right, guys. Let's get them started up, then we'll continue. We'll continue.
Okay,
discussion.
Twitch viewers. So let's take a look at our.
We'll have the three tanks
players here.
Two
We've
tanks.
Got
one
Team
tank.
Tiger
let's
Ball
go
Dog.
Center line tank only.
Looks like we have Ufric.
Copy for center line.
Viper. A few SU-17s. And some F-4s, which we don't care about.
Well, Chaff, we don't need them.
Zooker with the F-5s. I think we have everybody.
As far as I know, there shouldn't be any radar guided threats from air to air, so
Baldog,
you can dump the chaff Viper, if you wish.
Zucker and Ufric, that's only four, so we are missing somebody. And then over at Fishbed, we'll check it out who we got here. We've got Tony Quito, Scoops, 201, Tech, and Chimango. Not sure why we're seeing
they do have access to any ordnance that's available to the MiG, according to the post for the grudge match. And there are radar-equipped missiles. Just know we have a weakness in our RWR. It will tell you when there's a radar-guided missile launched, but it will not tell you when an infrared missile is launched because there's no missile warning system.
Copy.
Hey, Team Tiger, this is Hook. I'm only counting four Tigers on the ramp. Are you guys good?
I'm here.
All right, sound out again, guys. Baldo 1-1 is in the pit.
Tiger 1-2, checking in.
Viper 1-3, checking in.
Hey, pilots, this is Event Moderator here. I think we might have a desync. I'm only seeing four aircraft on one team. I hate to do it, but I'm going to ask everybody to replane. Go back to spectators and replane here now that the server's unpaused, and we'll see if we can get a clean break. This is not counting against match time.
I was seeing five Tigers.
Yeah, I only have four, so we'll get them to replane. It should give us a clean break there.
Raj.
Sucker's in the pit.
Ball dogs
in the pit.
In the pit.
Tiger in the pit.
Team Tiger, I'm looking at five Tigers. You guys are good.
Copy. All right, spool them up, guys.
If you guys are watching on Twitch, I know it's boring, but the action's starting soon. Just hang in there. Team Fishbed, I've got five Fishbeds. You guys are good to go. Thanks. Okay, viewers, tell me what you guys want to see in the chat. If I'm doing something you don't like, we're going to go through our players once again. For Team Tiger, or for Team Fishbed here, we got the team captain, Tony Quito, who seems to have a fan following in Twitch. Scoops here in the two spot. In the three spot, we got Frosty here. In the four spot, we have Chimango. And bring it up in number five is Tech. I don't try to say his full name. Now let's go take a look at Team Tiger. Over at Team Tiger, leading up the team, we have not this guy. Let's see if we can find him right. I love the white-on-white text there.
Check your speed brakes, too.
There we go. Baldog. Baldog is number one. Number two is going to be Tiger, GR Tiger. Number three spot is Viper. The four spot is Zucker. And the five spot is Ufric. So there's our five Tigers. Let's talk a little bit about strategy so far, guys. It seems like DCS is really loud on my end, so let me try turning that down. Okay, I suspect you guys might be able to hear me better now. So, looks like Team Tiger's opting for the two missiles and the fuel tank. At this point, I don't see any ground ordnance on their aircraft.
Make sure
that may mean that they are going for a strictly defensive or offensive air-to-air strategy. Let's take a look over at Team Fishbed. Now, keep in mind, if you guys weren't here for the briefing, the two ways to win this match are outscore on air-to-ground kills and combined aircraft kills, or kill all 18 of the enemy's aircraft before the match is over. If we look over here at the airbase, Sochi Adler, and hit resources, we'll see that aircraft Seem aircraft is giving us a bug here.
Viper 1-3 ready to taxi.
Bummer. We'll have to go by score then. Well, the idea here was that aircraft would tick down from 18 as it did in my testing.
Tiger 2-1's ready.
That, DCS is betraying us here, so we'll keep that in mind and we will have them count their respawns. No problem. At this point, it looks like Team Fishbin may be opting for a split air-to-ground, air-to-air strategy here. I thought I saw a couple S-24 rockets, but maybe they have reconfigured for air-to-air only. So it looks like we may have us an air-to-air clash. We'll keep it on Team Fishbin for a few minutes here. Let's see a crash. It wouldn't surprise me, Viper. It would not surprise me. Attention all aircraft. This is event moderator. You are clear to taxi and hold short the runway.
Thanks.
Okay, does anybody need more time?
This is Tiger, ready for taxi.
Oh, are you ready to go?
So there we go, Twitch viewers. Team Fishbed rolling out to the flight line and stacking up at the runway here.
Let's all right, let's take Team Tiger.
And we are currently in Team Tiger's comms. I'm also recording Fishbed's comms.
You got 3-0 and 1-2.
But we can switch over to Fishbed
let's
later
take,
in the match.
I think that's runway 3-0.
Team Tiger is still in the huddle, it
seems.
Yeah,
that's fine.
Waiting
for whatever's a shorter taxi.
Taxi 2
yeah,
and hold short. Looks like they're
right,
looking for
that.
The proper runway there. And let's take a look here. Fishbed is already holding short. Feel free to send me a whisper. Yeah, Viper, I sure appreciate that, buddy. I will take you up on that. Do me a favor. I'm going to give you my email address here in Twitch chat. Just contact me via email so we can talk about that.
Viper,
I really appreciate
did you just start
that,
rolling?
Yeah.
Actually, here, I'm going to have to
okay.
do it from
are
my
you leading
PC.
Us,
stand
our
by,
two ship?
Yeah, I'll take us out.
You all ready?
There you go. Shoot me an email there, bud, and
ready.
I will contact you.
Let's go.
We're going back that way, or?
I think it's back this way, isn't it?
Yeah, it's back that way.
Okay, guys, so it looks like Team Tiger might be just a little bit lost heading to the runway here. But that's okay. They have the odds stacked against them, so we'll cut them a break tonight.
Yeah, you think you should drop those too.
So a little more pre-match discussion here, guys. The Tigers definitely have got their work cut out for them. The MiG-21 is faster.
Yeah.
The MiG-21 is better armed, and the MiG-21 can outclimb. The one true advantage the Tigers have in this match is
you
maneuverability.
I'm on your left
they have
here,
automatically
I'm
deploying slats
around,
and
yeah.
flaps. Definitely increases yeah. the aircraft's handling. Some stability systems that the MiG-21 doesn't have. They actually have better air-to-ground capability, but will they take advantage of it is the question tonight. We will see, but either way, we know that Tiger is going to have their hands full. So they are the underdog, in my opinion, but I might be completely off base. We will see. That's why we're having the match. All right, so Fishbed's still holding short. Event moderator all channels. Team Fishbed is holding short. Team Tiger is taxiing. Standby. Event will be commencing shortly. Okay, guys, I'm going to be quiet towards the channel for a second so I can talk to all these guys. All right, back to the Twitch chat here. Red have ace pilots, Frosty and Tony Kito. Blue have broken missiles. Well, let's not be so pessimistic, you know. You never know. Maybe one of these Tiger pilots is a diamond in the rough. But yes, I agree. The Tigers are definitely at a disadvantage tonight. We will see how it goes. Okay, Team Tiger, moderator here, report holding short for me.
All right, copy. We're waiting on one more. He's rolling now. We got four. We're ready.
Copy. Okay, there's Team Tiger in their taxi. Again, at Team Fishbed here. The Soviet interceptor was...
Okay, guys, we're going to take off as a single. If you guys want to take off two-ship, you can. If you want to go single, it's up to you guys.
Turn down team speak just a little bit, guys.
Break traffic, and so we can join up, and then we'll proceed north.
Yeah, two-ship. All right, everybody, hike your gear. Gear's coming up. Down.
Okay, time to talk to the pilots one more time.
Alright, both two fighters ready to go.
Copy, Tiger. All channels break. This is event moderator here. We're going to give you guys one quick talking to, then we'll turn you loose. Unfortunately, our aircraft counting system at the airbase is apparently broken, despite my multiplayer testing. So the first team to reach 18 aircraft losses will lose. So I will call that out. I apologize. Nothing changes from where you guys are concerned. At this time, Team Tiger and Team Fishbed are holding short and ready. Fight on, fight on, fight on. Match is commencing. There you go, ladies and gents. The match has started. The epic battle to end all battles. Will the Tiger or the F-5 take it away tonight? The Tiger or the F-5, host bias. I mean, the Tiger or the Fishbed, we will soon know within 75 minutes by my timer. And I'm going to start two timers so I don't fuck this up here and lose track of time. It's currently 11 after at this time. Let's start my second timer here, guys. And I'm going to check the chat here. Email sent kind of short. Yes, please enjoy watching this. Captain Jack, good stuff, good stuff. Yeah, all right. Feel free to ask me questions as you guys get the opportunity. I will do my best to answer them. My attention is mostly on the aircraft in question here. There's Team Tiger departing now. What a pretty airplane. Even if it doesn't stand a chance tonight, it's definitely winning in the looks department, in my opinion. And I do like the Fishbed, so don't think I'm biased. Let's take a look at Team Fishbed. They're probably already halfway to Tiger's base. There they go, rolling out. Awesome. If anybody's got in the stream, has the ability to capture this using Shadow Play and the available space, I will be much appreciative, guys. You can shoot me an email, let me know you got it. I think my capture methods are working correctly, but Shadow Play is fighting me tonight, so we'll see how it works.
Where's Airborne?
Different Airborne.
Okay, and there is the man of the hour, the fearless leader of Team Fishbed, with quite a cult following, it would seem, here in the chat, Tony Kito. And testing his countermeasures, very understandably, being a MiG pilot myself. I know how those countermeasures can be. They only work when you don't need them.
330, be advised, 3 and 4 will form up on your left side, then we'll ingress and...
Okay, and you guys are currently hearing Team Tiger chat. We will switch later on here to Team Fishbed. And let's take a look at Team Tiger. Right now we see Team Fishbed is just crossing over the red border here. And Team Tiger appears to be formed up and on its way past Sukumi at this point.
It's alright, just knock the dust out of him. Come on, rejoin back.
We will see how the action goes once they get closer to each other.
Sorry, I lost video. Go ahead.
So we can confirm at this time that Team Tiger opted for air-to-air missiles and tanks. So it would appear that they are going totally offensive or defensive air-to-air strategy in this fight. Nice combat spread formation there, looking good. We'll check in with the team captain here, fearless leader, the underdog, the bulldog here in this F-5 Tiger.
go ahead and lights off, armed up.
Yeah, it sounds like they're fencing in.
Fence in, guys, and make sure you keep your radars off for now.
Haven't heard any AWACS chatter yet. I'm not sure if I don't hear it because I'm in spectators. That's very possible with me being game master here. Here's Chimango here.
Continue the climb up.
Heading towards the fray. And Tech, of course. It looks like the MiGs are opting for a spread here. Now, that is interesting.
And leads airspeed
they are splitting off into two groups of two. Tech bring up the rear. I don't know if that's deliberate or not, but if so, that's a very interesting strategy here. They certainly could fold around the Tigers' flanks with the Tigers being grouped up in a sort of a loose combat spread. Very interesting indeed. I get the feeling that Tony Quito has a bit of a reputation from you guys in Trat. You'll have to let me know. And a great commentary by Flankerator. Hopefully you're not being sarcastic. I'm doing my best. I'm certainly no announcer, but I'm trying to make things interesting for you guys. If you would prefer me just to be quiet and let you guys enjoy it, I can do that too. But I figure it makes more sense
if
I'm telling you guys what's going on.
Viper.
It is. Awesome.
Opinion.
Thank you so much, Flankerator.
You
guys in Twitch chat, Flankerator is an awesome guy. Been really helpful with me getting this thing together.
Okay,
and I really appreciate his help.
Okay, push it on up, guys. You're going to be at 15,000. Zucker, do you mind
turning up team speak a little bit?
Not a problem. Stand by.
Good. Keep us posted.
Okay, so the Tigers, again, looks like they are opting for a tight combat spread. The fish beds are certainly spreading out here into two groups. Looks like a flanking maneuver is very likely at this point. Here we have Chimango's fish bed, Tony Quito, and Scoop. Okay, definitely going pack hunting here in the canyons between the two bases. Very interesting. Very common MiG-21 tactic being low and fast.
I'm not getting any radar missile tone
just
from
over
the
coast here in a formation three. Looking at Frosty's MiG right
now. Okay, we got two groups, guys. They're lower than us, so let's keep our eyes peeled down there.
Okay, F-5s are definitely on top of them.
Let's go ahead and level off for 15.
Forward-looking radar. We're gonna pop on over to Team Fishbed here. Now hearing Team Fishbed's comms.
I have them on scope.
Yeah, three ship.
Yep.
Four ship. Five.
Yeah.
Frosty now.
On
radar.
You want to turn in, Salt?
Yeah, it's turning. Yeah,
two flanking bandits here moving through the canyons, not with air-to-ground ordnance, so I don't think it's a deep strike attempt. It looks like they are coming in to flank the rest of the group. Very
get
interesting
him with the
strategy there for Team Fishbed.
Okay,
I don't at this point see that type of strategy going on with Tiger. They seem to be gaggling into the fight.
So watch out.
Okay, this is it, guys. The bandits have seen each other. They are turning in higher.
10 clicks now, head on.
Here we go.
I still have a little more on my tank.
And we have a missile in the air. Fox 1 call.
So stay high and start looking.
Okay. Okay, I'm not sure if this missile
released. You're high. You see that on a 2
my missile's not shooting.
Yeah, I got two flankers.
That's it. Let's go.
Bulldog coming in with two in trail. Here we go, guys. I don't know about y'all, but I'm stoked.
Thanks,
this
Tom.
Is badass.
All right, let's go. I got him on radar.
Okay, both teams flying past each other. Now, Viper and Zucker did break off from the main formation. I'm not sure if the fish beds saw those two or three Tigers coming behind them, but the Tigers certainly see them from the way it looks. This could be very interesting.
Our left flank as well.
Yep, that's Tony Quito and Scoops coming in hot to the fray. May sneak up on Bulldog, it looks like. And we have a missile release,
They're flaring.
Okay, and we have a splash, I believe.
I don't see that.
Yes, we do.
On the other one, guy 6. Okay, one is...
That looked like an R3R radar shot, I believe.
Turning in.
Okay, we have Ufric here in the F-5s, tracking on a MiG-21, trying to line up that narrow shot.
I'm your 6.
And at this point, the Tigers are lining up in sort of a wagon wheel and trail. Not quite a wagon wheel, more of a chase, but they have one more pilot on their side, so they could turn this to their advantage. Tiger GR now coming into the formation, probably trying to visually ID those targets while he can. That is the tough part with no labels.
Lost him now.
Okay, we have Fox 1 on ball dog here.
He's my 6 now.
And did it hit? Did it hit? He is wounded. He is wounded badly.
Yep. I am extending.
Guys, okay, now MiGs are defensive here. We have a missile in the air. We have two missiles in the air, but they're both going to go wide. Zucker's missiles will go wide. He has ejected.
Flare.
Okay, 51st Frosty just had a close shot with him now. Cannons going on from the F-5. We have three F-5s versus two MiG-21s in good cannon firing positions. Looks like he's trying to help out his MiG in front of him. Chimango is trying to support Frosty, but he's got a bandit on his tail too here, taking lots of cannon shots.
Yeah.
Tony Keto and Scoots coming in quick to help. We got a missile in the air. Did they call the shot in time? Okay, that missile is going for the countermeasures. At this point, Zucker's got to bail out his buddy. We have a nasty merge up here.
Yeah, you have
Zucker chasing Chimango, Tiger GR, and his wingman, Ulfric, now chasing Frosty.
Break high.
Down pilots respawn authorized. Okay, missile in the air, splash one for Team Tiger.
Yeah, I'm done.
Zucker now chasing his bandit. Team Fishbed did have a pretty interesting strategy sharding off there to get the kill on Ball Dog, but it's put him at a disadvantage in the furball here. Tony Kiddo coming in and splashing Ulfric here from behind. Okay. Very interesting.
Still my six.
And Scoops on the six, taking down Ulfric. And it looks like Tiger GR Tiger has been splashed.
I'm pulling up behind.
3-3-0
We now have one F-5 left. One F-5 versus
he got your bandit.
Four
yeah,
eggs.
I got your bandit. And your six is
not looking good for Team Tiger. I'm still, hopefully they will respawn and get in the air quickly
here. Yeah, that's... Fly directly up.
We're going to hop over to Team Tiger's comms here. They may be in disarray.
Oh, God, he's trying to disengage.
Okay, and we see that Zucker is still aggressively chasing his teammate, but does he know that his wingmen are splashed? Certainly, so it looks like he's
stick around.
Pushing here hard to get a kill.
Got it.
And it's going to be guns only. Both his sidewinders are in the air. We've had a missile release. R-13, it looks like, but it definitely fell short.
I'm making my run.
Rat Zucker will opt for a defensive strategy here and attempt to peel off. Yes, indeed, he has. Tony Keto is quickly in trail, though, releasing a missile on Zucker. And the missile has missed. Zucker is off clean for the moment, but he has a MiG-21 on his tail, and the MiG-21 certainly has a speed advantage.
Push these,
he will not outrun that MiG.
So I can tell you guys who these guys are. All right, I'm running back south.
Okay, there's Zucker talking to his teammates, turning up the voice cards for a second.
Roger, I'm going to get up and cover
you. Running out, Angel.
33 statsing out.
All right, I'm dragging now. He turned around.
There goes Zucker now, trying to use that agility, and it looks like he has C-fitted. Zucker has C-fitted. So after the first merge, guys, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 losses
lead,
on Team Tiger and one loss on Team Fishbed. So
base.
That is 5-2-1. 5-2-1. Let's pop over to Team Fishbed's comms and see how we feel about that.
Can you loiter for a bit? I'm going to land and refuel and rearm.
You did have some damage, it looks like, in Chimango's MiG.
Yeah, I'm 1.3.
Tony Kino got out of the fight with a clean nose. Chimango radome is damaged. Tekkit got one with a clean nose and with a full ordnance there. And Scoops recently replaned, I believe, is now heading back out to the fray.
I'm back. How's it going?
Okay.
Good.
Back at the base.
It's okay. We splashed. We killed 4 of them. 5 of them, actually.
We will see if the
Tigers
get back up in the air quick enough to protect
we
the
lost
base.
Frosty, I think.
The
lost
MiGs
Frosty.
Have an advantage here.
Guys,
they
have
time
damaged,
to rearm,
so have to land as well.
Repair, and get back to the
okay.
fight.
Okay. Who's staying up?
I'm out of Sochi. Airborne.
Okay. Copy that. I'm inbound for Sochi right now. Runway.
Okay, so I know that the fish beds are at a big disadvantage. Let's check out the chat here. Or, I'm sorry, the Tigers. Let's see here. Yes, definitely domination for Team Fishbed. Man. Now, I will say,
this is shit. I got
I
a lock
on.
I never got
has
a
some advantages
missile, you know,
over the Tiger, but in my opinion,
I couldn't fight the
Team Fishbed played a much tighter round in that first merge. Their strategy was a little risky, splitting off like that, but it was very interesting to see how once they isolated a F-5, they got back in there and took out the rest of the team. Very good cooperation.
Got him blocked.
You just gotta hold down the button.
Let's go see how Tiger is looking.
Yeah, I did. It was like 5 seconds hold. And still
wrong missile select.
No. Because it wouldn't.
Coming up on 13 minutes into the match now, so soon we'll hit the 15-minute mark. Looks like we have Viper departing.
Pylons. Right pylon selected. That's weird.
Oh, but I don't know. That's weird.
So my concern right now is that Team Tiger is a little disoriented, and they're going to split off in single ships instead of reorganizing and going in a group departure. Had a crash here on the ramp, Ufric, it looks like. Let's check out the scores there.
Yes.
Yeah, it's two ships lost. Looks like Ufric may have had a ground accident there of some sort. So that is unfortunate. That is going to cost Team Tiger, it looks like.
Finals?
At least one
I'm on the runway. I'm going to taxi out.
Oh, okay.
Okay, we got two Tigers departing now. We have Viper on departure.
Okay,
and we have Zucker taxiing and Ufric, I think, replaning here.
How many did we splash in? Four.
All five.
Is that right? All five. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, Scoops is now pressing into Tiger territory, it appears. Frosty and Tech, I didn't hear their chatter, but it seems that they're loitering for just a little bit. I wouldn't be surprised if the MiG-21s need to go back for fuel soon. Looks like two of them have returned. We've got at least one on the ramp here, rearming and refueling. MiG-21 team, or Team Fishbed, seems to be opting for a strategy of trying to keep aircraft on station instead of going back as a team, which is very viable. Team Tiger appears that they're circling the wagons here and departing as a group. Let's hop on over to Team Tiger's comms and see how they're looking. Give you guys an overhead view here while we talk. All right, let's take a look and catch up on the chat for a second here. Okay. Yeah, we did have a F-5 taxi crash on the ramp there. Operational accident is what it can be classified as, but unfortunately it will still take one of the F-5s. K-50 versus Gazelle grudge match? Well, I feel like that might be kind of one-sided too, but we'll see what we can do, guys. Looks like we got 31 guys viewing right now. Sure appreciate you guys watching. After the first round, for those tuning in now, Team Tiger was defeated in a 5-1 loss. 5 Fishbeds were able to splash 5 Tigers. However, 1 Fishbed was lost in that initial merge. So the game is not over. A couple good merges on the Tigers' side of things, or maybe even a deep strike into the base, could turn the score just a little bit, but right now Team Fishbed holds a 4-kill advantage, and it seems like there's some real talent on Team Fishbed, so that's going to be tough to beat.
Who else we got coming up?
Tiger 4 just took off right after.
We're going to see if Ball Dog can rally the team.
We're feet wet over here. Just the
Tigers are now feet wet. Is he here? Ball Dog saying. Sounds like spirits are okay. They're beaten but not broken here, as we have 3 Tigers forming up. Payback time on MiG-21s. Let's see if they can get some. Now, if Team Tiger uses AWACS, there is an opportunity for a power play here. Fishbed may have won that initial merge. However, Team Tiger did come back in force here. So we have one bandit out there by himself, which I believe is a Scoops. You can hear Team Tiger talking about it.
I got your bandit.
And it looks like they're actually going for the bandits right over the airbase at Gudyata. Scoops is sneaking in behind them on their northern flank here. Fully armed and probably in a reasonable fuel state. Correction, he's almost fully armed. Okay, so in the chat, give me a shout out if you're pulling for Team Tiger here. Let me see the Team Tiger fans in the chat today. Anybody? And then we'll look for the, I forget there's a delay here, and then we'll look for the Team Fishbed fans here.
You guys got your radar on?
No, I don't.
We're going to stay with Team Tiger's comms here a little bit and see, with them being the underdog, what they can do here.
One of those bogeys is going down. He's descending now. He's cold.
All right, guys, so it looks like what we've got going on here is a fishbed deep striking, or attempting to get in behind, rather. Deep strike isn't the word. He has no air to ground. He's definitely attempting to get in behind and take out any Tiger reinforcements. But we do have a power play here for the Tigers. The other side of that is we have two very good MiG-21 pilots here from what I can perceive, so this is going to be quite a merge. Okay, there's an R3R shot. R3R shot. They saw it. It looks like they are attempting to evade. Very nice jink. Very nice jink by Team Tiger. That was Tiger GR Tiger there with that evade. Awesome. Very beautiful. Okay, MiG-21 slotting in. Tiger GR Tiger is giving a chase here to the lone ship. MiG-21 in front of him. We've got 51st Tech coming in behind. We have a wagon wheel of three F-5s and one MiG-21, a Tiger GR Tiger chasing Frosty here, trying to line up that AM-9 P-5, I'm sure. The missile is in the air. It is chasing, but it is going after countermeasures, and I know that Tiger GR Tiger is hating that. Another missile release and another miss. So he will have to go guns or go home. Okay, Viper is now attempting to line up. I'm going to turn up chat here and keep quiet for a second.
That's twice for me, guys.
Different armor.
Okay, Ball Dog has crashed. I think he may have seafooted there in the maneuvering.
In addition to that man that you're pushing.
51st Frosty pushing out, or is he extending? Hard to say. We've got one Tiger here with two AM-9s. Tiger GR Tiger having fired both of his in the merge, and Zucker with two AM-9s. Let's see if they can line up one of those impossible, elusive AM-9 P-5 lock-ons in this current 1.5 build of DCS. I know it's not easy.
I got a shot. Hang on.
Okay, we see a Tiger low here on the deck trying to get a shot at 51st Tech, but not for long. 51st Frosty screaming in here from the west, here to help out his wingman. It looks like it was an extension, not a retreat.
All right, negative. He's out of here. There's another one here.
And
so
as you can hear on the comms, those MiG-21s are majorly taking advantage of that speed advantage here. Something I predicted on the onset during my series on YouTube, that the MiG-21 would hold over the
F-5. Are you up over the top?
Very difficult for the F-5 when your enemy can go 0.7 Mach faster than you that quickly. Okay, Tiger GR Tiger now attempting to line up 51st Frosty here. Viper's calling out that MiG at 3 o'clock, lining him up. If Viper doesn't break soon, he will be broken by a missile, that is for sure. And yep, and very smartly he's turned into the bandit. That bandit now screaming past him here with the enemy on his 6, but look at the speed, guys. 671. The nearest ship chasing him is 100 knots slower. The MiGs are just in total control of this engagement, not even because of the problems with the F-5 at this point, but because of their speed. They're able to extend out at a moment's notice and turn right back into the Tigers here, which has proven to be a real problem for the F-5s.
You pushing or pulling?
I'm coming on his tail now.
There we go, two Tigers forming up on Tony Kito's tail, the team captain of the Fishbeds, but he is using that energy advantage to his advantage here. Definitely in some hard G's right now, 202 knots for Viper, And we've got 450 for Tony Quito, so he holds the energy advantage at this time here. As three Tigers attempt to desperately line up a shot and a kill on Tony Quito. Let's take a look at the bigger picture. Looks like we have
21 in front of me.
Three other MiGs rallying, circling the wagons up here just northwest of the battle. And two other Tigers coming in, and another MiG way back deep in enemy territory, unsure what he's planning at this time. Tiger GR Tiger really trying to line up that gun kill, but in a gunfight, speed matters more than anything else, so that's a real problem for him, having no AM9s.
Got a puff of smoke that I
had. Total on the score so far, guys.
Oh yeah, that's a
looks like we've lost 1, 2,
he's going
3,
up.
4,
he's going straight for
5, 6 Tigers, and looks like just one MiG at this time. Just one MiG. That is tough. And two of those have been C-fits, I believe, or maneuver kills. Okay, missile in the air from Frosty, R-60 in the air. It's going for the countermeasures, and then we have another one burning a motor. Missile, it was an AM9. Lots of missiles in the air right now. Zucker's got one right on his 6. Unsure if it's going to hit or not. Looks like it went wild. Huge exchange of fire there, guys. Huge exchange. Look at this. This is just beautiful. Tiger, missile in the air from a Tiger. Will it hit? The motor's burning. No, it will not. It went straight into terrain here. Another missile flying. Just missing a Tiger's butt there. That missile looked like it was from Frosty. We've now got a real clusterfuck going on here, guys. Excuse my French. Looks like we may have just had an aircraft splashed or C-fitted. We just saw one drop off a radar here.
That other man is clear.
That's Zucker.
I got this.
Okay, they AWACS. That is what Scoops was doing. He has taken down their AWACS. That is a huge situational awareness loss for the F-5s here. That is going to suck. Okay, we did not lose an F-5. We still have three here, but we have split. We have Zucker being chased by 51 Frosty and Chimango leading him on. He is hungry for that kill. He wants that gun kill bad. Still carrying at least one AM9, so you know he's just so close to this kill he can taste it. Unfortunately, you'll see there's a MiG-21 lining up on a 6 in short order. He's going to be the one who's going to be getting defensive here. Two Tigers appearing to possibly...
I got a kill. MiG down. Coming back.
Okay.
Nice kill, Zucker. Get back to here and help out.
Okay, Zucker just splashed somebody. Zucker just splashed a MiG. AM9 release. I missed it. Sorry about that, guys, watching, but we had an AM9 release. Severely damaged MiG. That's the MiG-21 of Chimango. He has ejected. That is a kill for Team Tiger. But Zucker may not enjoy that victory for long. He's being chased by MiG-21, and it looks like we've got guns being fired by that MiG-21 in tow, flown by 51st Frosty. Look at this. Tigers now hold a pretty significant number of advantage here. The power play is on the Tiger's side. We've got reinforcements probably on their way. Ball Dog rolling out of the base now. Four elements of Team Tiger now rallied up and circling the wagons.
Roger that. I lost the fight. Looking for you.
I think he's on your tail. He's on your tail.
All right, 1-1's back in the air, guys.
Missile shot. Right.
Tony Quito taking a shot at the Tiger in front of him.
Keep going.
Flares have destroyed that. Good lord, that was a hard hit.
Who died?
Me. You.
Okay, Viper splashed, it appears.
I got no joy on
MiG. I'm sorry, it was Ufric. Ufric splashed by a MiG-21, Tony Quito. Devastating shot. He popped flares, but that missile just had his number.
Who's dropping flares?
That's a MiG.
Okay, Viper recognizing that dispense pattern, I suspect, and knowing it instantly that is a MiG-21. Team Tiger's in a real tight spot right now, guys, because they are out of missiles. They cannot run at this point because they certainly don't have a speed advantage. So their only help right now is that their two teammates scramble out of their base and get back to the fight as quickly as possible.
Come on, buddy, let's go.
They have lost their AWACS.
Yeah,
so that is a huge situational awareness loss for them.
Alright, I got him.
He's on the MiG.
He's on someone's tail. Someone that just go down. Alright, he's off. There's another MiG behind us. I'm rolling for him. Stay on this.
We'll wait till the action ends, but we are coming up on the 30-minute marker. 30 minutes here into the match, guys. We'll review the scores again. A clear advantage right now for Team Fishbed at this point. Two Fishbeds lost. However, it looks like we now have 1, 2, 5,
I'm on a
6,
right-hand
seven,
turn. Are you on a right-hand
eight.
Turn?
Okay, eight I'm right off your right-hand side. So far. Let's get back to the fight here. Viper now chasing the MiG-21 Fishbed flown by Tony Kito. Zucker on his right wing. Tiger GR Tiger is being chased by Tony Kito right now. Looks like Tony Kito is still carrying missiles, and he is hungry for an R3R kill in a pretty good position.
All right,
we got to
think about breaking off and going home.
Not anymore. Tiger GR has turned into the fight here. Now here in talks of breaking off and running from Team Tiger, but can they do that at this point? I don't think they can disengage from this fight unless MiG-21 Team Fishbed wants
to. Whoever's that other F-5?
And Tony Kito seems to be a very proficient MiG pilot, so I don't think he'll let him run so easily. And from the right, from the east, sneaking in, Scoops, low and fast, carrying one missile, probably low on fuel, but also returning from a victorious AWACS
hit.
Okay. Looks like he will pass unnoticed, parallel to some F-5s. Those F-5s were going
here,
home, but they know they're in an argument now. They know that they are low on fuel. Viper committing to the kill anyway. Does the MiG-21 see him? That's the question. If Scoops doesn't see Viper, Viper stands a chance at killing this MiG.
Go on.
There comes Viper screaming in, hungry for the kill. The MiG-21 this time doesn't seem to know he's there. And he's defensive now, spotting at least one of the F-5s, but perhaps not realizing that one is lining him up for a gun kill at this time. Scoops is now defensive, knowing he's being chased. That F-5 is coming in hot, very hot at this point. Oh boy, this is going to be interesting. This is going to be very interesting. Guns in the air. Viper with Team Tiger trying hard for the gun kill, and he splashes him! Team Tiger
fired.
Gun kill!
Nice job,
excellent
man.
Shot by Viper, risking nautical or aquatic death, running out of fuel, but splashing Fishbed. And I'm sorry if I get so excited, I know I'm supposed to be impartial, but it's pretty cool to see Tiger splash one at this point, with
good
it being
shoot.
So one-sided, so you guys will have to forgive my lack of impartialness there.
Whoa, dog?
Fuel level is now master caution.
Okay, guys, check it up on the chat here to see what I've missed. Top ace Tony Kito to you. Tony is flying a very tight round. Let's see here. Viper, I see some Russian there. I think Suka, I know what that means. And lots of F. So nothing too much coming
right,
from the chat channel
here.
I'll check in with you guys in a minute.
Yeah, no, I'm just I'm fixing to turn back. And backside top cover for you.
Event moderator, all teams, be advised, 30 minutes have elapsed. I say again, 30 minutes have elapsed, 45 minutes remain. Team Fishbed, you hear that? Just making sure, thanks.
Alright guys, it's 3-7.
Liet Atik Govrush Govru Puruski. Ah boy, I haven't taken
we've
Russian
lost three,
forever.
They've
I've
lost
always wondered
where we've lost seven, they've lost three. We're losing.
Yes, we are definitely losing.
Minya
Slavik
Suka. I can't read it that fast. Okay, guys, so interesting matchup. Let's take a step back from everything. So Team Tiger returning semi-victorious here in that exchange. They were able to splash a MiG-21. However, one aircraft was lost, so we'll call it a trade. Scoops was sacrificed, or gave his life, I guess, to take down the enemy AWACS. That's a pretty tremendous situational advantage for Team Fishbed. However, the F-5 does
have
onboard radar, so let's
I'm gonna die. Great. Awesome.
Oh no!
8-3.
Viper just lost control and crashed here. Something went wrong on his aircraft, so that will cancel out Team Tiger's advantage.
No,
not sure what went wrong with his aircraft there. He just took a quick dive for the ground. So at this point, we have three MiGs returning. Ufric on departure, Viper now replaned, and we have tech from the MiG-21s and Rage on the way back out to the AO. Seems like the MiG-21s are opting for a shift work of sorts. They're kind of having part of the guys stay at the base and rearm, the other out on station here. So they're trying to keep a presence where Team Tiger at this point
I got home
is
play.
Opting
I'm
for
up for
a
long final.
Monolithic one team, one fight strategy here going in groups. Interesting. We're going to pop up to Team Fishbed's comms here and see what's going on with them.
Right. Weather is important.
Tony, are you up?
I am ready up. I'm ready.
Looking back
to,
at the
I'm
chat comments
the
here, Stimpak is telling the truth. There has been
you.
More operational
okay,
accidents,
on the main.
Possibly that
okay,
F-5 losses. But okay. Then again, it's a new aircraft, so we'll have to give them the week or two after release excuse, I suppose.
Almost forgot my emergency brakes on.
No, even the self-test isn't working. I'm missing something here.
Say again, what's your issue?
Okay,
radar's
guys,
not
looks
working,
like,
I don't know why.
All the MiG-21s are RTB.
It takes a while.
Everybody's heading back to base.
It takes
here.
4 minutes. 3 to 4
we
minutes
are more than halfway through the match.
Never works,
33 so. Minutes, rather. We are not quite halfway through.
Let it warm up. Put
so,
it on the middle
we'll see how this plays out
as
both teams rearm and come back, hopefully,
a
into a nice
okay, but
I'm light show
is there
for us.
Something I need to turn on apart from the radar
switch?
No. All you do is put all the black switches on your main panel to the right. Flip all those up except for the gun camera, because that just obstructs your view, and just wait it out. You just have to give it some time.
Okay.
It's a very, very docile baby. You need to treat it very, very kindly. All right, we'll regroup. Scoops, you're going to form up on me. You guys form up on yourselves, and we're going to press in on Godata again.
Where are you at, Tony?
I'm flaring once. I'm eastbound. I'm bearing 110. I'm flaring twice.
Okay, guys, I'm going
to
total up the
to
score
your left,
here.
I think.
Carefully
yeah,
to
I
make sure I can tell who is who and get the right teams.
Is that you guys just passed?
No. That's
no.
Okay.
That's tech.
Oh, we have F10 map. I forget. Never mind. Yeah. Okay, I got you.
Okay, guys.
We're allowed to use that,
reporting
or?
The scores now, it is 10-2. 10-2
I mean,
in favor of Team
I
Tiger.
I think we're not disallowed
to. I'm going
to
do a score report over here so everybody knows what's going on. It may impact
how
we
I see you anyway.
Yeah, Rich, let's turn in.
Copy. Are you ever Soshi?
Yep.
Okay, turning off.
Actually,
right.
I'm not going to report the scores because that may demoralize Team Tiger even further. So at this point, we are going to leave it running here.
Flying once, just so you know, Saul.
Visual.
Hmm?
I flared once.
Yeah, I got you.
Copy. I'm going to...
I'm a little high, but 90. I got you.
Buster.
Am I two for this?
Sorry, repeat, I have no cockpit.
Am I two?
Yeah, technical one now, Benzie's taking lead, I'll go
right.
Three and Stinger.
I'll be two.
Flanker of the chat there.
I don't hear anything, how
yeah,
can I be a lead now?
10-2 currently right now. Three of those are operational losses, I believe. Seven losses in combat.
Okay,
two victories for Team
off.
Tiger.
We got
and,
some
Team Fishbed is in a strong
breathe. Let's group up real good, real tight.
Time.
Get them with their pants down. Let's try that tactic again. Let's go for the mountains. What do you say, Scoops?
Okay, there you go. That's Team fine. Fishbed rolling out in force. Once again, splitting off for their tactic here,
Which,
depending on flanking.
Make
last
zero,
time,
nine,
it did work for them. However, if Team
copy,
Tiger had flied
zero,
a little bit of a tighter
seven,
game,
eight.
I could have seen it going badly for them. So let's see how this plays out in round two. It was an aggressive strategy. It paid off in dividends. But it could be turned, especially if Team Tiger
tank,
watches each other's asses
well,
and comes
it's around
in force here.
Copy.
You can tell when your main fuel tank is empty because there's a green panel at behind
top
your
over
stick.
To Team Tiger
and
see
left
what they're playing in here as they are TV. Okay, do planes being manned there at the base? I still don't think that the aircraft limits are working properly. They are not, unfortunately. Not a surprise. DCS always has to throw a curveball at us, but we're okay.
We got a funny feeling that these guys are going to try and sneak through the mountains.
Yeah, I think that too. Or at least they'll try to come here. I bet they're confident now.
Yeah.
All right, Baldo, I'm going to go ahead and come up now, and I'll join on you. We can go check it out a little bit.
Roger.
Why do you say avoid the mountains?
The two, three players that they're on the opposite side, they love mountains, that's why. Bring them to the open.
No, I have no intentions of going in the mountains. Trust me on that one. One tack that we can try, guys, you know, it's just going to be a matter of whether or not they're going to bite on it, but we can get them to commit to coming back closer to our base. I mean, they're probably too smart from that, but at least A, they're in the clear, and B, we'll have some support.
Yeah, I just don't know if we'll be able to get back because they're faster. I've got you off my nose, Baldog. I'm forming up on you.
Copy.
Okay, guys, interesting commentary there, team discussion by Team Tiger. As you guys can hear, the team captain expressing his opinion that he has no desire to enter the mountains. Now, that is interesting. I would say that to armchair quarterback it, I might actually opt for the mountains because the Tiger's energy advantage is definitely not there. I'm sorry, rather it's an energy disadvantage. However, that maneuvering ability could certainly be exploited around terrain. So let me know what you guys think in the chat about that. But personally, I think out in the open water, open plains here, Tiger is at an energy disadvantage and can be exploited. And we're seeing a familiar formation there as Team Fishbed splits into two wings, two ships of two with 51st Frosty. Excuse me while I plug in my headset so we don't lose power. 51st Frosty bringing up the trail there. Team Tiger now circling the base in a three ship, clearly waiting for their other two ships to get up and running. So far, nobody's opted for an air-to-ground strike. That's interesting, and it probably would be pretty risky to try such a thing at this point in the game. However, with Tiger being at such a score disadvantage, you know, a deep, aggressive strike using their superior air-to-ground ordnance is a viable strategy at this point, especially with them being able to carry a pretty good amount of flares and the possibility of defeating those air defenses. We'll turn voice comms back up a little bit here and let you guys listen in.
Vipers on your left, Baldog.
Copy, coming left here.
And it looks like Tony Quito headed to the front line again here with his wing and trail. Rather in combat spread, I suppose. Looks like he opted for two semi-active radar homing missiles and two R-60s. We'll see. Tech also is headed into the battle. He did opt for four R-60Ms, it looks like, and two, I believe that is the R-3R. Rage here, also in trail, really with R3Rs, I'm sorry, and 4R60s.
We do.
51st Frosty also carrying that same loadout. So it looks like Tony's the only one who's bringing less than the full loadout. Nope, I take that back. Scoops is carrying four missiles. The Tigers all carrying fuel tanks and two AM9s. Now they could tighten up the fuel tank usage. I did see a lot of guys maneuvering with fuel tanks the first round, and that's not going to give them any slack here against these MiGs. Okay, so we have three Tigers going into a fight outnumbered here. 51st, Rage, and Tech have turned, deliberately drawing the Tigers into a trap, I would suspect. So this is going to be very interesting here. And keep in mind, Fishbed does have the advantage of AWACS right now. Zucker turning around here to support his teammates. on departure, and we have Tiger GR Tiger taxiing to the active. So hopefully right, only a few point behind, a few northwest. Minutes behind their team, who's going to desperately need them, especially having all lost their situational that. Advantage. If AWACS was still available for the Tigers, I suspect they would know that they are possibly being led into a trap here. But that game mechanic has been exploited by Team Fishbit.
About 10 miles, our altitude, I can't get him locked up. And he just disappeared. I think he was lower than us.
Heading into
a I had visual on him, he's our altitude, a little lower.
Three F-5s. F5 is having trouble
right
keeping.
Below us, right
yep,
down
they have
now.
Spotted. Viper has spotted him.
Right on the water,
two
guys.
Two ship has not spotted the Tigers, or are they deliberately drawing
Cali.
Them in? I can't tell.
I got a visual
sure.
on you guys.
I'm coming right on
Viper
his tail.
Slotting in right copy. Behind 51 Tech.
I'm supporting.
He has spotted him. Tech is now evasive. Tech is now evasive. Viper again maneuvering with his fuel tank. Huge flare dump here by Oh, he's going cannons. He's going cannons. Unable to clinch that cannon kill. Ball dog sliding in behind Tech. And where did the third F5 go? The trap has
taking
been sprung.
Shot.
The trap has been sprung.
Where'd the other one go?
And crossing. Scoops coming in hot to support their teammates.
Okay,
it appears this was
bad.
Quite deliberate by Team Tiger. Or Team
where'd the other one go?
We just merged with them.
Attempted a deflection
Roger.
Gun kill.
They're crossing in front of the other mid.
There is now a numbers advantage for the MiGs, guys.
Copy.
This is going to be
one.
Rough for Team Tiger. If they
Zucker,
do not take
you?
Somebody down soon, this could be very
10 seconds out.
Whoa, he just crossed right in front of me. I got this third guy.
Okay. It appears that Baldog is trying to cover his wingman's tail. It will cost him his 51st raise. Lines
who?
Up Baldog for a shot. I am not sure
okay,
if Team Tiger...
Guy.
Oh, and Viper has been... or Baldog has been
well,
splashed.
I don't know what happened.
And as you can hear, Baldog's confusion, totally unaware of Team Fishbed slotting in behind those two Tigers. And Baldog very obviously frustrated there. That trap
no, there was three of them.
By
yeah,
Team
we had
Tiger,
three, didn't we?
Or Team Fishbed rather, expertly sprung. That was simply beautiful. They brought Tiger right into the fight. Tiger got kill hungry, which is very understandable, and those two MiGs slotted below them without them even noticing. That was
whatever you guys do, get airborne.
Strategy.
There's three of them here.
Zucker now by
still
himself.
Still got lives left and time left.
Actually, with four MiGs, thinking only three.
Isn't it three per player? No, it's 18
no,
lives,
I'm sorry,
period.
Five MiGs. We have... Yes, we have the full
dang
fishbed
it, I'm low
team
on E,
here.
And this guy's pulling
the
away
from
me.
Full fishbed team against Zucker. Zucker must be entirely
all right, I'm engaged with at least two of them. Make that three of them.
Tiger GR Tiger looking for his teammate, but no situational awareness, and without communication, he's going to have no idea where his
one
teammate
of them just
is
went in the deck.
Him.
Make that two. I got two MiGs.
Right. The missile released. Zucker flying. The bolts, the rivets even,
three.
Out of
three
his
MiGs.
Tiger. Will he C-fit,
and
though, cutting
I'm
it so close?
God
he
dang.
Has C-fitted. He has C-fitted. A trade-off there. One MiG-21 has C-fitted, and Zucker has C-fitted as well. Tony Quito, the man of the hour, the captain of Team Fishbed, pushed his MiG just a little too far tonight, it appears, guys. Going back to my estimated advantage that the Tigers would have in the terrain, so they should continue to exploit that, but we're going to have to tally scores and see how much more breathing room they really have. So a trade-off there. We have lost three Tigers versus only one MiG. Tiger GR Tiger now sharded out from the rest of the group and merging in by himself against four MiG-21s. And take it a quick moment here to make sure we've not exceeded match lives. 1, 2, 3, 4, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 Tigers. 14 Tigers have been used. That means only 4 are remaining. We will let the aircraft plane and take off until the 18th Tiger is killed. Okay, so going back to the action here, Tiger GR Tiger in scissors with this MiG-21. Trying to line up a kill. Is he aware of all the health the MiG-21 has with him? There's a deflection shot. He's been completely jumped by four MiG-21s. He is totally defensive here. And a real mess. Is he still going for the kill? At this point, it looks like he's defensive, probably just looking out his canopy, trying to understand what the hell he has walked into here. Low energy state, only 180 knots, and we've got hungry fish beds, very hungry fish beds breathing down his neck here. Does he have help coming?
Viper's taxiing.
We've got four F-5s taxiing. Eufrick on departure, but he just will not get there in time to bail Tiger out of this mess. Unless Tiger pulls some serious moves and manages to stay defensive for a good 4 or 5 minutes. Okay, flares in the air there, denying him that shot as Tech climbs out of the threat zone from that AM9P5, which is about the size of a pea. And let's take a look at chat here, see if we got any commentary about that fight so far. MVP the ground, yes, most valuable player may be terrain this time. Let's get back to the fight here, guys. And it looks like Tiger GR Tiger has been downed. I apologize for missing that kill while I checked the chat. Looks like he was splashed indeed by an R13 M1. And that kill goes to Tech. That means that there are...
I just pulled out. Taxing.
We'll check. 5.
Roger that. I'm on you.
9. Copy. 12. 15. Only 3 Tigers remain before the match ends. 3 MiG-21s been splashed.
Hey, look, 1 o'clock.
So right
you
now
see those
it is
15-3
hey, in favor of the MiG-21s. Kay. MiG-21's just taking it away right now. At this point, I would love to see a Tiger last-ditch air-to-ground strike. But will the Tigers attempt it? At this point, they seem to be in disarray, so I'm not sure it's going to happen, guys. I see we got 42 viewers now. Appreciate you guys tuning in. If you're just tuning in, we are currently... as of the moment I'm saying this, 49 minutes and 16 seconds into
the
75-minute match, we have
15
Tigers lost
versus
3 MiG-21 fish beds. Really been taken away by the MiG-21s this fight. Not entirely because of the disadvantages of the Tiger. I've seen some real good skill on the MiG-21 team. And I've also seen some great flying on the Tiger team, but the MiG-21s as a unit have just been more cohesive, and that's playing to their advantage. And my throat is sore. Oh, my God. So we have Eufrick now merging with 51 Frosty. There they go in scissors. Eufrick is hungry for a kill here. I know he's ready to splash these guys. He's come close a couple times in the match, but just hasn't been able to line up the shot.
Two of them over the
Eufrick
water.
Popping flares. Probably a little spatially disoriented, unaware of that MiG-21's position. He is slotting in behind that MiG. If he'll just bleed some of that speed and use his turn rate advantage here, he may be able to get a shot off. But the MiG-21, flown by 51st Frosty, flown expertly this time, he is turning just in time to deny Eufrick that shot. But his energy advantage is quickly going away. Eufrick is now trying gun kills as he attempts to maneuver in behind Frosty's MiG-21. Some high deflection shots here. And we have a hit from behind, from behind. He has been ambushed by his teammate, 51 Tech. Let's switch over to the comms of Team Fishbed to hear.
Outbound right now.
Excellent teamwork. 51 Frosty was able to keep the F-5 Tiger by Eufrick, drawing a blank there, busy just long enough to deny him shot. That now brings the tally up, I believe, to 16 Tigers lost. They are within 2 Tigers of losing the match here, guys.
Frosty, didn't you know that you had a bandit or what?
Yeah, but
a little communication from
the I'm visual on a bandit, feet wet, just south of Sukumi.
Check your fuel rate.
1.4. Oh, I'm being fired on. Shit.
Okay, 16 Tigers lost, guys. 16 Tigers lost total here
visual.
To 3 MiGs. They have 2 left before
scanning.
The match is over.
Shot.
If they can turn a couple merges around, this may go longer.
Splash one.
Good kill.
Okay, we just had a kill called.
These missiles are just not locking on. I don't understand.
A little frustration with the missiles
there
day,
on
so Team
nice.
Fishbed.
I'm on a 6. He's gating, and I still can't get a turn.
It looks like Scoops has been splashed. That is 17 Tigers. 17 Tigers. They are within
that,
1 Tiger of the match. Ending here
northwest of
at 52 minutes, so approximately or a little over 30
if
minutes early here.
At Godata and,
I'm sorry, 20 minutes early.
Keep them away because I'm
two missiles in the air. Five ball dog really trying to line up his kill. Did he splash? Did he splash?
My engine's just cut out.
He splashed one. Ball dog has scored a kill on a MiG-21.
I'm hit.
Rage has been taken down by ball dog. Let's go to Team Tiger's comms there. Nice shooting by ball dog with an AM9P5. Unfortunately, he can't revel in his victory for long, ladies and gents. Gents, mostly, probably. Because looks like 51 Frosty is slotting in right behind him. Viper now scooped with merge. Viper now merged with scoops. And the Tigers will not go down without a fight, ladies and gents. But they are being forced defensive. Ball dog being totally unaware of 51 Frosty slotting in behind him. Definitely focusing on helping his teammates here, which is totally understandable. But he's got to keep that SA up here. Missile in the air. We got a missile released. Ball dog probably totally unaware, but that missile has missed. That missile has missed.
I'm on that mid.
Okay, Viper now slotting in behind. Slotting in behind 51 Frosty here. If Ball dog can land the gun kill, they have a fighting chance here. They certainly have a fighting chance. We got a missile in the air. Ah, the missile missed. It just missed. God, the Team Tiger need that AM9 P5 to hit. If it ever needed it, it was then. MiG-21 uses surprisingly energy bleed off to turn the tables on Viper expertly. 51 Frosty now chasing, attempting to line up either Baldog or Viper. Scoops running from the engagement. Missile in the air. And it's hit Baldog. Baldog has been splashed. I hate it for Team Tiger there because they had a fighting chance. 51st Frosty, though, well-deserved victory there. Excellent maneuvering, especially being chased by Viper. That was outstanding. Now we have a square off, and possibly guns only. No, we have three missiles still on 51st Frosty's ship. Viper with no missiles at all, but in a position to potentially line up that gun's kill. Has 51st Frosty lost his SA? Does he know the Viper's there?
Just one.
Scoops coming back in for the kill here. More excellent coordination by the MiGs as they extend out, clearly communicating here. Missile released. And it goes wild. It goes wild. I almost thought it would chase Frosty's MiG-21 there. Viper beautifully maneuvers onto the tail of 51 Scoops, pulling a similar move. Two scoops then was pulled on him by Frosty.
I have to get a ruling on this, but I'm under a canopy right now. I'm under shoot. So I don't... I mean, I'm talking to you like I'd be talking to you on a shortwave radio, so...
Let's just pretend.
Yeah, I'm watching it go down. It doesn't look good for you, my friend.
Okay, we are within one F5 Tiger.
Yeah,
one F5 Tiger of the match.
Three on one there.
Yeah.
And there we go. Viper splashed. 18 Tigers lost. 18 Tigers lost.
ASAP.
55 minutes into the match, guys. That's the match. We're going to talk to the players here and see what they say. Viper putting up a good last stand there to the best of his ability, but two MiGs with missiles versus his unarmed F5. It just didn't go for him. Attention all players. Attention all players. Event moderator here. 18 F5s have been lost. I say again, 18 F5s have been lost. I'll verify that count here just to make sure. But go ahead and hold it. What you're doing if you're on the ground, hold your departure. If you're in the air, disengage temporarily. We're going to double check here, guys, and make sure we got it.
That was embarrassing.
Did that ground collision get us over the 18?
I don't think it should have.
Yeah, event moderator to Team Tiger's question. Yes, any aircraft lost are going against the scoring here. So we're going to have, that's the only way we can calculate it. Okay, we have you 5 losses by Team Fishbed. Team Tiger clearly not happy about the ground losses counting towards the score here.
Next time we'll have a little more than less than a week to practice.
Yeah, that's no kidding.
Team Tiger not too happy with me, as I'm sure.
Missiles never miss.
It's all that matters.
Okay, Team Fishbed, we've reached the 18 score limit here, so we're going to probably go ahead and knock it off and have you guys RTB. Good flying on your team there. Is everybody happy? Any remarks?
No, I'm happy, dude.
Cool.
I mean, come on.
Yeah, we five fish beds were lost. They did lose 18 Tigers, three of those to operational accidents on the ground, but in fairness, I had to count them, just like I counted sea fits. Okay, I'm going to pop back up to Team Tiger.
Parallel with them, you would get engaged and the two guys in the mountains would come in.
Okay, guys on Team Tiger, just letting you guys know real quick, unfortunately, final scoring is in. 18 Tigers lost, 5 MiG-21s splashed. To be fair, I did have to count ground accidents and CFITs because I can't differentiate, unfortunately, between total aircraft loss. So this time...
Hey, they're attaching our base right now. I thought you called us.
I'm going to call and knock it off here. I'll call and knock it off. But everybody RTB here, and Tony Kito's probably going to get splashed by Sam's anyway.
No, he's defeated it.
Okay, Roger, I'll call.
Disrespectful.
No water. No water on Team Tiger or Fishbed tonight, guys. All aircraft. Knock it off. RTB.
Go home,
RTB.
Tony
Kito's gloating a little.
Yeah.
I've got one on the tone. Should I fire?
Yeah, kill him. They want to keep going.
Nah, the match is over, so you guys do what you like at this time till our aircraft are on the ground.
Okay.
Personal vendetta settled between Tony Kito and Team Tiger there.
Tiger
GR Tiger himself settling the score for those ground attacks. So there you go, Twitch. We'll watch the aircraft recover here. We have a clear victory for Team Fishbed tonight. Now, granted, the Tigers were definitely at a disadvantage tonight due to the inherent bugs with the plane. However, Team Tiger flew a or Team Fishbed, rather, flew a very tight match. So, guys, thanks for tuning in. I'll be quiet for a few minutes here, but let me go ahead and conclude my stream by letting you guys know I really appreciate it. Looks like we got up close to 50 viewers. I hope you guys enjoyed it. We're looking at doing a series here in cooperation with SASim.com. Flanker Raider, again, thanks for all your support. I appreciate everybody watching in the commentary here. And yeah, too bad that final kill didn't count. But yes, final score is 18 for the fish beds, 5 for Team Tiger. So 18-5 going to the fish beds here in round one. Thanks again for tuning in, guys. I really appreciate it. And if you guys are still on the stream here in a few minutes, I'll talk.
Yeah.
We can out-turn them and out-fight them, but they outrun us. I think that's what we can walk away with. Always have some reserve. At least covering us from above.
Event moderator, all aircraft, once recovered at your airfield, go ahead and pop up to the pre-match brief channel, and we will debrief the match here and talk about everything. Hope everybody's happy. A lot of good flying on both teams. It was really fun to watch, and the stream seems to have enjoyed it. So thanks a lot, guys. See you up in the pre-match brief channel.
Cool.
All right, good fight, guys.
Viper, I see you. I'll check that email for sure, bud. And hey, thanks a lot for the compliments there, guys. I know I'm not much of an announcer, but I'm gonna do my best here in the future to stream these and when we can, when it's fair.
For the future with this, you know, it may get bigger and broader, so there may be more room for time.
Yeah, Flank Raider, thank you. Definitely hop in for that debrief. You are all welcome here.
As a team. I don't know.
I ask if you join is just let me give the official debrief, and then we'll let the pilots give their remarks, and then you guys are certainly able to jump in.
So if that can be worked out, you know, that might be something we can do. So, but anyway, guys, I had fun. It is what it is. You know, at least it's a game, and we're not all burning piles of rubble on the freaking earth.
Hey, Air Dog.
We don't know how to fight with these things yet, but I definitely think that this definitely proves that we need to have a fam flight for it.
Yeah.
Hey, Team Tiger, real quick before Ball Dog leads. Look, guys. Yeah, the card stacked against you hard. You put on an excellent show. Team Fishfed played some very tight tactics tonight, okay? So keep it in mind that not only did they have the aircraft with some obvious advantages, a couple related to bugs, but also real-world advantages, they also played a super tight game. So don't beat yourselves up. Very honorable fight, and I really appreciate you guys being here. I'll see you in the debrief.
Cool.
Good lead, Baldog. Good job.
Thanks, man. I appreciate it.
Good work, bud.
Good job, Baldog.
I know this motivates me to do a fam flight, Baldog.
Yeah. Channel switched.
Okay, gentlemen. Everybody's going to pop up here for the debrief once they're recovered, and we'll wrap this thing up. Air Dog, thanks a ton for the host. I'll let you know when everybody's recovered so you can close.
All right.
User joined your channel. User joined your channel. User joined your channel. User joined your channel. User joined your channel.
Server's coming down in 30 seconds, guys. 30 seconds. Eject, land, whatever you will. User joined your channel.
Hello.
What's going on, guys? If you're joining here from Twitch, welcome. Do me a favor, hold off until I give my debrief and the team captains can say their piece, and then we'll open up the floor to anybody who wants to chat.
Hopefully, the AI will fix it.
Mid pilots, you guys, I just want to say y'all flew a very tight game. You had some great tactics we didn't see until it was too late, but kudos to you guys for holding your own and keeping your composure when your buddies were in trouble to be able to come down and help out.
Thank you.
Zach, tactic consists of aggressive.
You guys also were no. You guys weren't no AI. We had to earn our kills with you guys.
Good sportsmanship. That's what I want to hear.
Very good flying.
Okay, guys. Lord Angel, thank you, buddy. If I saw you in here, I would have banned you. Just playing, man.
Yeah, I think I can speak for everybody that this should be a continuation at some point in time for sure.
Oh yes, definitely.
Yeah.
Okay, guys, I'm going to take the floor real quick, not to interrupt. I really appreciate the good sportsmanship. Give me just a second. Hey, 51 Rage, if you read me, hop up to the debrief, pre-match brief channel here. We'll debrief. Okay, guys, this is Hook here. If you were just joining, I'm the moderator and the guy you heard on Twitch tonight. So let me run with my moderator debrief. First of all, I really appreciate all the contestants joining in. It means a lot to me to have such a good turnout and, more importantly, such good sportsmanship. Great attitudes on both teams. I was listening to the comms. User joined your channel. Obviously, Team Fishbed has won tonight with 18 kills. Team Tiger bringing it home with 5. So I know that there may be some hard feelings or heavy hearts on Team Tiger, but I just want to remark from my view, and I think probably from the view of the Twitch viewers, the Fishbed, or the Tiger rather, had a lot stacked against it tonight, has a couple beta bugs that we're contending with, and the other aspect is Team Fishbed flew an incredibly tight game tonight. Both teams had some good pilots, some good tactics, but Fishbed on two particular occasions, which hopefully I'll be able to show you guys via recording, had some very, very sharp tactics. So to both teams, outstanding work. You have nothing to hang your head over. This was a lot of fun. Everybody enjoyed it. And if you want payback, we'll get it. And if you want to defend your title, you'll get the opportunity too. So I'm going to hand it off to the team captains for their debrief. We're going to start with Team Fishbed's captain here, Tony Quito. Go ahead and take it away for us.
All right, thank you. Well, honestly, I was really afraid the first time I started flying against F-5s and DCS F-5 versus MiG-21 servers. I was honestly very afraid that we would get we would get completely blown away by the F-5's turning rate and agility and such, so on and so forth. But I found that the MiG-21 has its strengths as well, despite not being very fast on its legs in terms of turn rate. It has very good, let's say, boom and zoom capabilities, and we employed the various tactics, real-life tactics and makeup tactics to subdue the F-5 team, which have been trained. I personally trained this during a long while, during this week and so on and so forth. And my teammates, they were fantastic. They were well-qualified people of the 51st, which I've seen on the blue flag doing amazing work.
and really putting the Russian pride up there, and as well as my other teammates, China, who was also a very good pilot that had to tag out with Rage because of the lack of pilots, and as well as my good friend Scoops, who was there with me, and he can be my wingman anytime. That's it.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate it. Great leadership on your team. Great teamwork. Very competent MiG-21 pilots tonight. So F-5, you have nothing to be ashamed of. Those guys flew an excellent game. And Baldog, Team Tiger Captain, take it away for me, bud.
Well, I'll keep this short and sweet. I can definitely tell that there was some good adversarial teamwork over there, and I appreciate the group that I had. We definitely we felt the heat for sure. So with all that said, I'll keep it short. Let me say it this way: to be continued.
The gauntlet is thrown down. The gauntlet is thrown down. And finally, from our sponsor tonight and co-moderator, Flankerator. Any comments, sir?
First of all, thank you guys for the great show. I personally enjoy it a lot. That was an exciting match, and I'm definitely looking forward to the next one. Also, great commentary from moderator Hook. Excellent job, and really enjoyed it a lot.
Thank you, sir. I'm humbled by your response, and I really appreciate your help. Participants and viewers, I'm going to open up a thread on the DCS World Forums, on the Eagle Dynamic Forums, for after-action review. So I want any input you guys have on this event, things you liked, things you hated, things you think could be improved or sustained, kept in the next one, please let me know. So I'm going to open up the floor for a commentary from the teams. Team Fishbed, any team members want to make remarks here? And then I'll go to Team Tiger, then we'll open it up to everybody.
Just to remark how many times I saved Frosty this time. Twice.
Very true, very true. Like I said, excellent teamwork. Any other comments from Team Fishbed?
Not particularly. The setup of the base was very good. The units and the distance was nice. But perhaps I think to keep it more variety and such, next times make other airfields. You know, not repeat the same airfield selection. So maybe next time do it. Tbilisi Bezlan or Mazdak Mirani Vodi, you know, open ground or more mountains or exclusively water. I think that would be an interesting battlefield experience.
Excellent. Okay, so next time mix it up, give us something new. I appreciate that. I am writing down what you guys say here on a notepad document, so thank you. Team Tiger, we'll hand it over to your pilots. Any comments, remarks?
I think building off of that, I think maybe next time we could have more distance, so we have time to get in the air and be able to work our radars more and be able to compose ourselves better. It was just we were getting in the air and they were over Tsukumi, so maybe we could have some more distance. That way we had to utilize better fuel management as well.
Sure, understood. Reasonable point there. MiG-21s are certainly able to exploit covering distance faster than the Tiger, and we saw that tonight for sure. Okay, guys, well, from my point of view and my job as the event moderator tonight, I am finished. Again, contestants, I owe you guys everything for showing up tonight, or we wouldn't have had an event. Excellent flying on both sides and excellent sportsmanship. Truly appreciate that. Thanks for tuning in, guys, and everybody is free to open up the floor how they see fit. Just try to keep it to a dull roar, I guess, so not everybody's talking at once.
Top ace, Tony Keto.
Disconnected from your channel.
I've got a question, if you don't mind. First of all, I'd like to thank Jesus for giving us this victory by the MiG team. Second, Tony.
Yes, hello.
Would you say that the F5 team got absolutely blown the fuck out? User disconnected
from your channel. Hey. I'd say that's a little bit harsh, but I would say that they did indeed get bought.
Greg got blown out because we're not going to have any lack of sportsmanship here from contestants or viewers.
Greg's a tit.
Yes.
Well, this is why I was hesitant to open it up to the floor here. Let's keep in mind, Team Tiger has a lot to contend with, especially in-game functionality. They have nice.
You have to understand, guys, first of all, to be fair, they have just had aircraft for a couple of like a week or something at most.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, we had 5 days. Well, we had the aircraft for, it's like lightnings were shooting down F-15s when F-15s were new, you know?
Absolutely.
Ask Frosty.
What I'd like to hear from the MiG pilots on what they think the F-5s could have done better.
Honestly, I think you one of the advantages, one of the main tactics we as the MiG pilots employed was staying low and looking out for large formations. And the thing is, we had our own pieces of large formations, but the thing is, you guys flew like very high, and we, with our ground intercept, we could find you guys very easily and get behind you, use infrared. And I think one of the things you guys need to exploit more is more flanking tactics, more, or split up groups and make like a pincer maneuver, you know, flanking. It's more about air tactics than proper flying in and of itself.
Okay, yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah, five
I
needs
think we were on the right